All right. Last night's episode of Raw was an interesting one. A lot of posturing and stuff. In some good matches too. But it's the last Raw before the Royal Rumble, right? So they're finishing up some storylines and such. First match was a tag team match that kind of saw some teams that have really been hating on each other lately have a full tag team match. We got Ludwig and Giovanni against the New Day. Kofi. My God, I'm forgetting the other guy's name right now. The hell's his name? Like, I know it, but it's just. There he is. Xavier Woods. I don't know why I couldn't remember his name all of a sudden. This one actually didn't have a winner because it was a double count out. It just got savage. They went out into the crowd, up onto some equipment. They all went through a table together and kind of it just ended when they were all down and injured.
At his pace.
This is Vinci looking at his best, crushing the knee there.
Shot after shot with ruthless striking. He manages to escape it.
Ah! Memorable moment.
Kofi Kingston has the power of positivity coursing through his veins.
Uh-oh.
No, no,
well
no.
scattered reversal there.
The U-turn Kofi needed in this match could have been that right there. Face first with a waistlock takedown. Kingston running into some trouble, guys. And Kofi needs to stay positive.
Mounted with touches and not... Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off. Ooh! And that stops whatever Kaiser intended. Look at this, going counter for counter. Clothesline to the back of the neck. Instead of a corner like that will render you useless. Lift off. Good lord, taking flight. Big time risk pays off.
The daredevil in you comes out when you take risks like that.
Just hot shot it to the out. Oh my god. Double underhook applied. Butterfly suplex.
Oh shit. He's coming at me.
Oh, strong impact. Taking this match off the mat now. From the top. Look out below. It doesn't matter if you're on the outside of the ring. There is no place safe when you face such a risk taker. And the referee gets...
Oh, I got the ref.
Makes him pay with a counter.
Oh shit.
Puts an end to that. Textbook jumping clothesline. Ooh. He's getting a little better now. Here he goes for the win.
And he closes it out.
Still in with a quick kick out. Where in the world does one find
him? Oh no, he could be caught here. Bad spot for him.
Stunning this play.
Oh. In the match. Sent right out of the ring.
Oh my god. Oh man. Ah, kick.
Nasty kick. Steered clear.
Ooh. Able to reverse.
Hooking it up here. What's next?
Oh no!
Tag made. Tag made. Wow, look at the power. French German suplex.
Did that just happen?
Oh, ouch. Oh, kick right in the back.
Shot after shot.
Oh, it's ruthless striking. Ooh. Muscling up there. Led him into this very dangerous situation. And bit by bit, he was broken down. Now he's practically sitting duck. And now gets tossed into the ring. Look at the height.
Splash.
Target square on Kofi. He's in trouble. Up top.
Oh.
Come on, Kofi, get up!
Big knee to stop the maneuver.
Xavier able to...
Into the cover! Oh, that's the cover!
Yeah! I backed him off enough just to... I didn't get him, but he jumped down off the apron, right?
Winners, Giovanni Vinci and Ludwig Kaiser, Imperia!
Two great superstars that go great together, and that wins.
Xavier never even got into the match, right? We gave him some beatings, but... Now, unfortunately, we can't do the next match because it was Ivy Nile, who is a more recent up-and-comer that came up from NXT and is aligned with the Alpha Academy, taking on Valhalla, who's the barefooted freak that comes out with the Viking Raiders. Neither of them are in the game, and in all the pages I scrolled through to get all those characters I got recently, I didn't see either of them. So they're just not... It's not going to happen, right? So we'll go to the match afterwards, which builds on another rivalry that's been going on lately. A little... The Lesser Lights of the Judgment Day. Who have been... Wait a minute. The Miz. Dom ended up winning. Of course, there was tomfoolery from Judgment Day, but it's too bad because I'd love to be The Miz. I love The Miz. But I haven't used Dom very often, so I'll get to use a different guy. Fully maybe used him once or twice.
Is a brazen loud mouth, but there's no question how Miz sees himself. He thinks he's awesome, and throughout his highly successful career, he's pretty much proven that claim to be true.
Well, The Miz might just have the biggest ego in the history of this industry, and that's saying something, but you're right. There's no denying that he's backed up all of his arrogant claims about being a talented competitor.
And now The Miz is ready to once again show the entire WWE Universe just how awesome he can be.
And in the other corner is Dominic Mysterio, a young star with a legendary heritage. When Mysterio comes to the ring, he's got a lot of proud Lucha Libre history coming with him.
And Mysterio has been soaking up all that handed down knowledge like a sponge. It's been a key part of his rapid ascension up the ranks. And that one misses the mark.
Oh, no. Oh. Oh, Miz, lay off.
Shares the same amount of spirit as his father. Is that enough to overcome his opponent here tonight, Corey?
Left foot.
He thinks he has it. And a kick out before the count even begins.
Doesn't go well if you still can't get more than a one count by now.
Ooh. Miz gets out of the way. Drop kick.
Ah, fuck.
It's their opponent's legs. That's a free fall.
Producing a trampling. Oh, look at the well-placed elbow way on the mark. He's taking some good hits. You can see the dismay on the face of The Miz.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Mysterio using his size to be more impactful.
Oh.
Fighting back against Miz. He's been placed in the corner now. Charging up the arm, and ooh, what a clothesline in the corner. This
Hold
was
on
not
a
expected.
Second.
Sheesh.
I was worried about this happening. And this superstar's waiting for him. Where's he at?
Uh-oh. Oh, this.
He takes control. Clothesline.
Oh no! Oh!
Dropkick
to the patella. The patella manubrium. Ah! Oh!
Ew!
Right to the face. Dives with a reversal.
Oh shit. Miz, stop. Stop.
Impressive counter. Boom, right in the button. Incoming! He leaves the ring, but he could lose this match by
count. What the fuck?
Oof. He gets what he deserves for all that gloating.
Wow, look at that agility. Dropping the elbow.
Dominic knows exactly what to do next.
The Miz caught off guard.
DDT.
It's nuts when they do shit like that. Like,
oh. Momentum has completely shifted to Dominic.
Not an A-list performance here from Miz.
Crank in the head. Attempting to boast here, perhaps not the wisest choice for the young Mysterio. Ref still counting, close to calling it.
Hurry back in.
The young Dominic Mysterio looking to fire up the audience here. He's doing a whole lot of gesturing, and it could cost him.
Oh, he just made it.
Back in, this one will continue. Stopped in their tracks with a knee to the gut.
Spinebuster!
With a sit-out. Nasty.
Yeah, this tracks. Miz never did meet a crowd he didn't know how to play to.
And look at this now. Yes, applying the submission hold.
Dominic gets caught off.
Now Miz, here he goes.
That backfired.
He kicks out before the count starts.
Truly cannot believe that didn't even get a one count.
Miz keeps blocking my punches.
And an neck breaker, vintage Miz. Bottom of the forearm smack. The end may be in sight for his opponent here.
Holding on by a thread.
Beef. Oh, oh, they didn't see it.
Picks up the win.
Here is your winner, Dominic Mysterio.
All right, let's go beat Miz with a chair.
Boof. And eked out the victory.
It was definitely the result of keeping their head in the game in this one. Hey, they were just trying to keep them on their toes here.
And guess what? They did. So it looks like a win-win to me.
Yeah, more like a game plan.
Oh, sorry, Miz. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just trying to get points. Oh.
Miz in a very vulnerable position here. He's about to do it. He's about to do it again.
Oh, on the concrete.
Mysterio with a tilt-a-whirl DDT.
On the concrete. That was a good match. Short, but full of adventure. Okay. Now I got to look at my files here. Ah, another ongoing kind of rivalry here. Ivar against another member of the Alpha Academy. I think the only one he hasn't faced recently. Chad McGable. Ivar got the win, but it was a good match. And I stopped watching after this match because it was just getting too late. I didn't know the match after this one was coming, or I would have maybe stayed up a bit longer and watched it. The thing that was coming up after this match was CM Punk and Cody Rhodes in the ring for a confrontation with just talking. And I knew that would have gone on forever. And I just didn't have that much time at the end of the night. And I needed to go to bed for work, right? I wish they'd done the match next, and then I would have stayed up for that.
And a perfect blend of the amateur and pro games. And for your information, Cole, the Master isn't a nickname. It's a title that he earned. Thank you.
Right, silly me. How could I forget?
Across the ring is Ivar, a one-of-a-kind party animal. Ivar always enjoys throwing himself headlong into combat and feasting with a large hunk of meat.
Ivar certainly does have a zest for life, and you're right about his love of combat. Few superstars look as at home in the ring as Ivar. You could tell this Viking was born for battle. It's easy to see the surprising agility Ivar possesses for a man his size. How do you contend with that as his opponent?
Disregard his body type and treat him like you would any other high flyer and ground him. Pile on the damage, keep him from going high risk. That'll take away some of his most devastating offensive abilities. Evading offense.
Oh.
With authority.
authority.
He climbs into the ring.
Arms are hooked. Opponent trapped. Powerbomb.
The powerbomb's not meant to be pretty, but oh man, does it get the job done.
Powerbomb is beautiful.
Sure be taking any more of those.
Kidding me?
What are we going to see here?
His plan here. Gable on the receiving end. Face buster. Counters. This could be an opportunity. Counter upon counter. Great minds thinking alike.
Spine buster.
With a sit out. Nasty.
Oh, this is just disrespectful. And an elbow drop, too.
Terrifying look for Ivar's opponent.
Ivar getting just as hyped as the WWE Universe is.
Big risk here. He may be counted out.
He might be oblivious to the count, guys.
We could have been looking at a count out there.
Oh!
That would have been a deflating result for
Grable.
The WWE Universe.
Ow!
And there was some force on that.
Son of a bitch.
Hooking it up here. Pump handle. Pump handle suplex. Right in the elbow, nailed it.
Delivers the leg drop.
A terrifying look for Ivar's opponent. Okay, already we get it. Stop looking for adulation for the crowd and get back into the fight.
Kick to the gut.
Double underhook.
Target bomb. Shot after shot. They're slamming their face down.
Ivar heads up. This is going to be good. Here we go.
Oh!
Bad landing.
Big miss.
Completely wiping out.
Oh,
and he's out and delivers a knee.
Knee chop.
Big time clothesline. Good grief.
Big splash. Gable needs to get his wits about him fast.
No.
He saw that one coming. And he gets delivered back into the ring.
Elusiveness from Gable.
The better part of valor. Oh, clothesline. This is what you call high risk, high reward. Perched up top.
Landing.
Taken out from high above. You gotta be some special kind of crazy to do that. Incoming.
Oh my gosh.
Consecutive high risk maneuvers, and the pace of this match has certainly picked up.
Kick to the gut.
Double underhook.
Target bomb.
No mercy being shown to Gable here.
Yeah, Ivar is appearing unstoppable.
They're slamming their face down. Ivar getting just as hyped as the WWE Universe is.
Working on the leg.
Come on, Chad.
Shot after shot.
What a punch.
Oh, no.
Reversal from Chad Gable. And he's taking this to the outside now. Check your face after that one. Momentum has completely shifted to Ivar. Gable has to gather the energy to turn the tables. Counters on counters. Technical prowess on display. Face.
Got out of it last time. Not this time on the concrete, though. See if we can end it. No problem.
It's finally over with the win.
Here is your winner, Ivar.
This kind of win is Chad went from ready, willing, and Gable to ready, willing, and beaten.
I love the breakout. You can earn a lot of bonus points. Like, using all the weapons gets you more move variety and stuff. Okay, so the next one was the tag team. I don't get to control the team I want, but it is what it is. Hallelujahs. Zoe Stark. Shayna Baszler versus one of my favorites, Indy Hartwell and Candice LeRae. No. It's the sound of strength in numbers.
And the bell is rung, getting this tag match started.
When you think of tag teams that are itching to make an impact on tonight's event, you don't have to look any further than these two.
Two teams with a desire to steal the show.
Partner to tag, she's in about as good a position as you could hope to be still.
Stop right in the arm.
Oh, break an arm.
Oh, shit.
Hazler now looking to go high risk.
Oh, no.
Shoots up the top rope.
Dangerous thinking.
From way up, thanks, Candice.
A chance, and it didn't pay off at all.
Ref, come on, come back over there.
Trying to ramp things up.
Gets the tag.
Clothesline, forcefully delivered.
Running knee strike.
Sharp clothesline.
Fends off the attack with an elbow.
Good
night.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Ooh, vicious kick to the spine. A devastating blow delivered to Hartwell there.
This is when you have to take advantage of tag team rules and get yourself some breathing room. No good reason to stay in this right now.
She goes for the pin. Oh, I thought it was over, but again.
Can we please get some control?
Elbow drop.
Piercing.
She is just desperately trying to fight out of it. Charm. Will that be the case? Indy Hartwell showing off a bit now.
Sharp punch.
And we just saw some serious offense.
Driven down face first.
Boom. Ready for a little bit of high risk here, it seems.
Taking flight. Diving body splash.
Opponent's not going to need a chiropractor.
Spectacular athleticism. Elbow drop. Great height. Hartwell struggling to defend herself.
Indy needs to be resourceful in this situation.
Quick exchange. Reversing to reversal. Unbelievable athleticism. Zoe climbs. What's on her mind? Thrown back into the ring. Look at the height. Nobody home for that one.
Starks looking to wrap this one up.
Zoe Stark.
Backflip into a face buster. Starks stamping an end to this.
Striking at will. The ref might want to stop this one.
My God, what a striking display.
Oh. One step ahead of Indy there.
Boom. Candice never even got in.
On point. Teamwork looking sharp. For my money, this is the best women's tag team around.
All right, last match of the night, the main event. Was another rivalry that's been going on and heating up. Drew McIntyre versus Damian Priest. Drew McIntyre won, apparently, because of some misguided helping by R-Truth.
And Damian Priest kicking things off here. A formidable superstar with new purpose, I think, in the Judgment Day.
Priest has completely refocused himself. He used to be about the light and the dark, and now he's all about punishment. Single-minded and ruthless as they come. I think we're about to see a side of him we never even imagined.
Bad news for anyone who steps in the ring with him, I fear.
But you can't risk underestimating an opponent like Drew McIntyre. He's a truly ferocious competitor. The only thing he loves more than just being in the ring is winning.
Yeah, there's no limit to what Drew is willing to endure or even do in the ring to pick up the win. I'm sure we'll see a tenacious effort from him tonight.
Tossing them aside, and Priest is being controlled here.
Scary to think what Drew has in store next.
And a stomp to the gut, too.
Showing out their deadlifting prowess and just, oh, that's how you establish dominance.
I honestly can't believe we just saw a human being tossed like that.
Off the ropes.
Brutal knee to the side of the face.
Boom! Priest holds him off.
To get the win.
I think Priest needs to look for ways to get the physical advantage. The more he can do to put his unbridled strength to work, the better. The power he can put behind his punches is his best bet at finding victory.
It couldn't have felt good being chucked around like that.
Getting tossed. He's heading to the floor, but he can't take his time. STO! Boom. And Priest not quite having the energy to prevent that one.
And McIntyre's aggression seemingly growing with each attack.
Tossing their opponent like they're nothing.
McIntyre now with an unrelenting attack.
Yeah, now Priest has to fight against the momentum against him. And a stomp to the gut, too.
Drew flexing his muscle as he attempts to rally the troops.
Into the barricade.
Five. And a big boot. Oh my!
Showing off their deadlifting prowess and just.
What are you guys thinking?
Obviously not about the ref's count, Cole.
Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Like a Terminator, McIntyre's eyes are seeing red.
He returns to the ring.
Fuck.
Lifting their opponent back to their feet and a thunderous right hand.
He's returning fire. Nasty roundhouse kick. And the tenacious McIntyre being subdued there.
Priest dished out severe punishment and his opponent is feeling the effects.
Oof. He's not going to be able to pull this off, is he? Is he?
Yeah!
Whoa! Uh-oh! Things just changed in a big way.
There is no reason for him to be out here. Oh, where are they?
Oh, square shot, but the back elbows ends that.
Scoop slam. Wait, nope.
Wow. Oh.
Outrageous strength on display.
to the core keep coming. McIntyre with a great shot. And more attacks to his core could hinder his offense. Is having problems here.
Drew is looking thrilled with the beating he's putting on.
Ooh.
Oh, that was just malicious.
That's disrespectful.
Ooh, what a jumping headbutt. Just mounted with punches and not. Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
He was elusive there.
Neckbreaker.
Priest tying that one.
McIntyre's just so dominant.
Priest.
And it proved to be well telegraphed. And out of the ring he goes. He's outside the ring now.
Hope he's got a plan.
Apparently my controller ran out of juice.
Oh man, they do not care who or what they destroy.
Yeah, Byron, you are dangerously close to being collateral damage in this one. Uh-oh, clearing off the announce table.
Oh, this is about to go from bad to worse.
This is not gonna be pretty.
I gotta get counted out.
Yeah, a man of Damian's size can do a whole lot of damage. Proof positive.
Get up, Drew. Get the fuck up.
He heads outside. Countout's legal in this match. He's heading back to the ring. And countouts are legal, so hopefully this will be a short trip outside. Powerbomb drop down.
The Scottish Warrior staring into his opponent's soul right now, trying to see what they're made of.
Dominating shoulder tackle.
Oh, ouch. Seated drop kick. Look at this raw.
Beef.
Suplex brings him down.
And the momentum's clearly against Priest now.
Drew exhibiting all his power and force.
Insulting.
Ooh.
Was just malicious.
Oh, that's just insulting.
Tossing their opponent like they're nothing.
Ooh. Escape just in time.
The springboard attack fails to land.
Future shot. DD.
Here's a cover. Could be it. On the ropes.
Oh. Well, it worked for him, not for Miz, though.
Offensive attack is why Drew McIntyre's a game changer.
Yeah, Priest needs to shift wherever his focus is over to the task at hand.
McIntyre turns things around. Clothesline!
What impact!
Does he have him here?
There it is.
it's worth it now.
Here is your winner, the Scottish Warrior.
Celebrate this win. You deserve.
Here we go.
Oh. Oh, look at his leg.
Something.
A steel chair? Something we all know can be a devastating weapon. Oh, oh, oh.
Good match, good match. All right, so as usual, we will finish up with a couple of wargums. Let's see if I can find any of my new guys. Oh, Ric Flair, shit. Ooh, Taz. He's a 94? Holy shit. Who's the other one I saw that I wanted to do? All the kind of the new guys I've gotten. Christian should be higher than a 75. Hurricane's not new. I've had him for a while, but I just wanted to use him. Everybody else here are guys I purchased last time, and I don't think I've used any of them. Well, six I didn't purchase last time, but...
First two competitors ready to go to battle in this true test of fortitude and will.
ready to go to battle, ready to take each other to the limit for their respective teams. We are about to witness some truly anything goes mayhem here in this one. Double the rings, double the cage, and double the destruction.
That's War Games for you. Unless you've been there before, few superstars truly know what's in store for them in a match like this.
I'll just leave it at this. Nobody comes into a match hoping to get chucked around like that.
And shockingly, Goldberg is being dominated.
Goldberg has been figured out.
And that was an effective attack, guys.
Big splash.
Compressing them with a splash.
Oh my God, doing it again.
Able to reverse that one. And he's able to counter. Really falling behind.
He's just on the wrong side of every maneuver.
It's about to be an uphill battle for one team once this clock hits zero.
Just a perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
Released from the cage and beelining it to give their team an edge in the match.
Kick to the gut.
Racked around into a neck breaker.
Right.
Big forearm.
And walking through the structure door, this is where nightmares become reality.
Enziguri finds its mark.
And you have to think there's a little more strategy coming into play at this point in the match.
For sure, and that strategy might need to come down to a minute detail. Not
what
just
the
who's
fuck?
Competing at what time, but even the types of moves you use. All short-term decisions that will be key to long-term success.
Oh, he's got him up high. The follow-away slam.
Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyper-extend your elbow.
Snap power slam.
I fucking got up.
Ooh, stiff punch.
Reinforcements about to arrive. Let's see what kind of impact they have.
Mark Henry's on the way.
The teams and looking under the ring for a little
sludge.
And that was an efficient form of offense. He just got sent flying into the opposite ring.
He's looking completely lost as he finds his footing.
Drop kick with precision.
Entering the ring now, hoping to give their squad some relief. Sledgehammer right to the gut.
Hard landing. Got it.
Like that sledgehammer can cause some serious damage.
Oh my God. My temple's getting rattled.
Oh, saw it coming.
Catches the
clothesline. Oh, fuck God.
Slips out of the way there. What reflexes?
Oh my God.
Looking wobbly in the corner.
Dismantling the arm in the corner. And what a throw that was. And that was a successful bit of offense with that maneuver. Goldberg counters with authority. Countdown underway. The odds about to no longer be even. And that definitely made solid impact. Here they come, looking to give their team the upper hand as soon as possible. Oh, this is not good at all. The pendulum backbreaker stretch. And Atlas offense with a hurtful purpose. That takes them down. Ooh, kick finds it.
He's made sure the odds are above and beyond his favor now.
Man, inverted backbreaker.
Sledgehammer right to the gut.
Oh, the sledgehammer.
Chamber connects.
That'll scramble your insides.
Oh my gosh, what impact!
Every successive move is putting their opponent in a dicey situation.
And this was a well-targeted attack.
He moved, but can he capitalize?
Reversal! Can he take advantage?
I fucking avoided that.
Taking the attack to the competition with that
one. Fuck.
Now that sledgehammer is just daring his opponent to move first.
An agile escape.
Another reversal.
Jesus, fuck. For a guy that was rated 94 or something, he's not avoiding a lot of this shit.
What a four.
We're seconds away from these teams being at even strength.
He's got the target acquired. Just a matter of moments.
Got the leg. Oh, a dragon screw.
That'll destroy a knee.
Another warrior about to enter the fray. Here to
fuck
the scales.
And he's able to beat Goldberg to the punch.
The teams are squared up, but he doesn't think that's enough, apparently.
So ruthless.
Impressive display of power.
And he keeps his focus on an attack to that area.
And they have.
Now look at this.
Can't quite get there.
Fuck off.
And Tagiri finds its mark.
The Hurricane avoids that one.
Unbelievable athleticism.
Oh! Downward force! Can he put this one away?
Starting to scale up the War Games wall. He's got something in mind.
Once more, see ya!
Definitely will not be.
You have to imagine we're hitting the late stages of this matchup. Deeper at this point.
It might just take that extra push, that extra inch further to create the difference.
Reversal. Can they go on the attack?
Countdown's on to get ready because this will give one team a greater number of combatants.
And did you hear the impact of that?
And again,
wear down your opponent.
First thing out of the cage, eager to capitalize on the situation.
Here's the pump handle.
Suplex!
Launched.
He is a sight to behold. Take a picture while you can, everyone.
And now, officially in the fray.
It pays to come in and have more friends than foes in the cage.
Grabbing their opponent by the skull and slamming them down. Oh.
Saw that coming.
Inflicted more damage to the leg.
On the top.
And
some serious damage.
Oh, strong impact.
And he's a ball.
You're insane! You're insane!
Devastating crash landing off the cage.
Get through the fucking ring!
You live with the results.
Jesus.
This is not where he wants to be.
He's headed up here.